Welcome to Section 13 of Introduction to Image Processing. This section is about applications of machine learning. Although the underlying computations are very different, functions that use machine learning often behave much like other image processing operations. For example, these inputs show the image identify function, which uses a process based on machine learning to identify the main object in an image. Here is another example. This shows the find faces function used to find human faces in an image. The result is a list of rectangles that mark the locations of faces. This shows those rectangles as highlights on the original image. One basic task in machine learning is classification, which can be done using the classify function. The classify function supports several built-in classifiers. For example, after selecting one of the faces from that image, this shows the classify function used to classify the face as male or female and to identify facial age and facial expression. In addition to these built-in functions, there is a growing collection of tools in the Wolfram Neural Net Repository. A neural net is one of several approaches to machine learning. The Neural Net Repository includes functions for a wide range of tasks, including classical image processing operations like segmentation and image enhancement, and a variety of non-traditional tasks like facial recognition and object identification. Starting with segmentation, the Neural Net Repository includes a network called UNet that is trained for separating the biological cells from the background in images like this one. This input loads the pre-trained network from the repository. Using this network requires some settings to the network and some pre-processing of the input and post-processing of the output, all of which is done in this function. That function can then be applied to the image to do the segmentation, which is returned as a mask. The mask is displayed here as a colorized image. This shows the mask as highlights on the original image. Another example from the Neural Net Repository is a network for artificially improving the resolution of images. To describe the underlying issue, first consider enlarging an image using nearest neighbor resampling, which came up in an earlier section. The result shows obvious pixelation, since nearest neighbor resampling enlarges the image by simply making copies of the pixels in the original image. The pixelation is especially obvious in parts of the image with fine details. There are several other methods of resampling to enlarge an image. For example, this shows the image enlarged using OMOMS resampling, which makes the pixelation less obvious, but the result is still blurry. Further improvement beyond the limits of classical techniques like these resampling methods requires so-called super-resolution imaging, which can be done using a neural net. This input loads a suitable network from the Neural Net Repository. This is a network that has been specifically trained for super-resolution imaging. For color images, it is sufficient to sharpen only the luminance channel of the image after converting the image to LAB color space. This input converts the enlarged image to LAB color space and separates the channels. The super-resolution operation will be done on the first of the three channels. This input sets up the network for the dimensions of the image in this example. And now apply the network to the luminance channel of the image. The result gives the differences in the luminance channel that are needed to sharpen the image. The sharpened image is constructed by adding those differences to the luminance channel and using the color combine function to reconstruct the image from the three LAB color channels. This display shows the previously resized image together with the image after super resolution. A close inspection, especially of the fine details in the image, shows the sharpening of edges and lines and other corrections to the effects of pixelation. There are also tools in the Neural Net Repository for operations that are not part of traditional image processing. For example, this input loads a neural net for determining geolocation based on an image of a scene from that location. Some of these neural nets are quite large and may take a moment to download. When that happens, typically a dialog box like this one is displayed to show the progress of the download. After the network has been loaded, it can be saved and is often automatically cached on your computer so that you don't have to load it again. The resulting model can be used to find the geographic coordinates for the location of an image. This displays that location on a map. Although the inner workings of these models is somewhat specialized, the general principles are straightforward. To describe some of the basic ideas, consider the task of classifying images of outdoor scenes as either daytime images or nighttime images. To get started, here is a set of images called the training set where the images have already been classified as either day or night. A simple classifier for these images can be constructed based on the mean intensity of the pixels in the images. These inputs calculate mean intensities for the images in the training set, and choose as a threshold the midpoint between the maximum intensity of the nighttime images and the minimum intensity of the daytime images. A classifier can then be constructed by simply comparing that threshold with the mean intensity of an image. Such a classifier can, of course, be incorrect for daytime images that are relatively dark or for nighttime images that are relatively bright, but the classification is correct most of the time. This process of identifying image features like the mean intensity of an image and using those features to classify images is at least broadly what is done by a classifier that uses machine learning. Such a classifier can be constructed by applying the classify function to that same training set. The result is a classifier function expression that can be applied much like the threshold comparison, but the machine learning classifier effectively uses many image features that are chosen automatically, and machine learning also uses many methods of classification, not just comparison with a single threshold. Applying the information function to this classifier shows that it uses a method called logistic regression, which, like neural networks, is another common method used in machine learning. This classifier can still make mistakes. The information for the classifier shows the estimated accuracy. The accuracy tends to increase with a larger training set. That classifier used a relatively small training set and separated the images into only two classes, but it is also possible to do classification with many more classes and with a much larger training set. One commonly used example is the Modified National Institute of Standards and Technology, or MNIST, dataset, which is returned here by the resource data function. This training data consists of 60,000 images of handwritten digits. To demonstrate the effect of different sizes of training sets, start with a training set that includes only 1,000 of the 60,000 images in the original training set, and construct a classifier using that smaller training set. The performance of this classifier can be checked by applying the classifier to some test images. This input loads a set of 10,000 test images, and this shows the performance of that classifier for a random sample of 10 images from the test set. Most of the results are correct, but as expected, there are occasional errors. One way of displaying the accuracy of the classifier for all of the test data is with a plot called a confusion matrix. This shows the confusion matrix for this classifier applied to the test data. The entries on the diagonal in the confusion matrix indicate images that were classified correctly, and entries off the diagonal indicate images that were classified incorrectly. Most of the images were classified correctly, although, for example, the confusion matrix shows that a handwritten 9 is often misclassified as a 4, and a handwritten 7 is often misclassified as a 9. You can also use the classifier measurements function to get the percentage of correct classifications. Now construct a classifier using all 60,000 entries in the training set. Training a neural net with a large training set can take a noticeable amount of time, during which the computer will typically display a dialog box like this one showing the progress of the training. The performance of the resulting classifier can be checked as before, which shows significantly better accuracy with a larger training set. You can also construct a neural network classifier for the handwriting data using a framework from the Neural Net Repository. This input uses the netmodel function to load an untrained neural net structure called lenet from the repository. That network can then be trained using the nettrain function. The result is a netchain expression that works in this example like the classifier function expressions. For example, this shows that neural network classifier applied to a selection of images from the test data. This neural network classifier is even more accurate than the classifier that was generated earlier. That's the end of the examples for this section. To summarize, here is some of the vocabulary from this section. This section described a variety of examples of functions that use machine learning, both using built-in functions in the Wolfram language and using functions from the neural net repository. The Wolfram language also includes a framework for building your own model, such as by using the classify function. You can find more information about machine learning by choosing machine learning in the Wolfram documentation.